Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Black Friday is coming up. It's the unofficial start of the holiday shopping season. And this year, Americans are expected to spend $5.8 billion. But before you make plans to head to the mall, the money coach, Lynnette Khafani Cox, is here. And she says you should actually skip those doorbuster sales this year. Welcome to the show.
How are you? I'm great. It's good to be back.
Well, we're good to have you. It's good to have you back because, you know, folks are getting ready to spend a whole lot of money. And experts are saying we're going to spend more or less this year. What are you saying?
Yeah. The National Retail Federation says it's definitely going to be more. Mm-hmm. Over $720 billion total over the course of the 2018 holiday shopping season. So that's up 5% from last year. People are spending some money.
Do you think it has to do with the morale of the country that spending makes us feel better?
I do think a little bit of retail therapy happens during the holiday season. But people do feel a little bit better. Unemployment has been lower, et cetera. Okay. And so if you're going to be out there shopping, I want to tell your audience about how to do it smart and how to make sure you're keeping your credit and debt on the right side while you're out there shopping and
all
right,
so let's get into those tips. You always have money saving tips for us every time you come, but now it's for the shopping season.
That's
so what should we know?
Okay, so my first tip is to beat the competition and get on the list.
Okay.
And by that, I mean that the competition is all the other shoppers who want the stuff that you have. There's actually a lot of deals that are available now. A dirty little secret about Black Friday and Cyber Monday is that those deals get leaked. And so you can get signed up for emails, text alerts, notifications ahead of everybody else using sites, free sites like dealnews.com.
Okay.
They'll email you, so you don't need to be out there. I'm like, why are y'all out there 5 o'clock in the morning missing time with your family and going through all of this, getting up stressed, beating the crowds and the traffic? Get on the list. There's a thing called online shopping. Use technology to your advantage.
Use technology to your advantage. Use that free website to get the deals ahead of time.
That's
right. So you're not standing in line. Some people like that craziness. I'm not one of them.
I'm not feeling it either.
No. Okay. All right. What is tip number two?
Okay. So the second tip is to use the right card.
Okay.
So if you have, if you're going to be using a card, a credit card, and let's face it, a lot of people are going to be using a card, you want to use a card that has either a 0% interest rate or very low interest rate.
Okay.
Also, please try to only charge what you can reasonably pay off when that bill comes around in January.
Yeah, that.
I know it's not going to be possible for everybody. If you're not going to do that, then at least set, you know, a 3-month limit where you pay it off. And a card that has rewards attached to it is better.
Right.
Cash back, hotel discounts, free travel, that kind of thing.
Okay, sounds good. Okay. Number three. I can't believe people are still doing this, but you say don't bounce checks.
Don't bounce those checks, and now it's more important than ever. Now, your audience really needs to hear me on this one, Rashawn. In 2018, some people are going to say, I'm not going to use my credit cards. I'm good, Lynnette. I'm using my debit card, or even I'm writing a check or using cash. Don't bounce any checks because in 2019, a new credit scoring system is being unveiled called Ultra FICO. Now, you've heard of your FICO credit score.
Yes, of course.
Bottom line, this new credit score is going to be looking at how you're handling cash. So people who maintain $400 in their checking or savings account and who do not have any bounce checks or NSF fees, overdraft charges, they're actually gonna get a boost in their credit score.
Oh, okay.
Y'all gonna have to have me come back and talk about this
one. Oh, we will.
The credit score, but this is something new. You need to manage your credit and debt wisely. Check out a site, creditsesame.com, to understand what's my credit score right now. They'll give you a free credit score, but also it's about personal credit management, learning how to access your credit, protect it, leverage it, and make sure that you're not overspending this holiday season.
Okay, all right, we are into number four. What's tip number four?
What I call the sell one, then buy one method.
Okay.
Everybody's gonna be buying tech this holiday season. They got a new iPhone out there, your kids are probably gonna be asking for that, or maybe the new Samsung Galaxy phone. My strategy is about taking what you already have and selling that before you actually buy something new.
Okay.
The average family has about 7 devices, old cell phones, tablets, different tech, just laying around in a drawer or something.
Right.
You wanna sell that first before and get the cash from it before you buy something new. Or you can even buy used but very good quality tech. Declutter.com is the website to do just that. It's a free website, you get their app, and they'll tell you right on the spot, here's how much we'll pay you for this old iPhone you have.
Yeah.
Or you can buy a newer iPhone, but at a discounted price.
Okay.
And again, the app is free. You send them back your stuff free.
You know what? I do have a little tablet that nobody has used in ever.
Get you some cash from that. Okay?
You know, I'm gonna do that. I'm definitely gonna do that.
That's a savings for this holiday season.
I like that. So, that's smart. Yep. We're definitely making you smarter this holiday season. And last but certainly not least, lock in your refunds. What
does that
right. mean?
Well, it means get that price guarantee. So again, using technology, there's a service called Earny. It's an app that you can use where if you buy something and later that merchandise goes on sale and your credit card offers you a price guarantee, Earny will automatically get the refund for you. So you don't have to remember, where's my receipt? Who had the discount? Did I check the price later and did it drop in value? They'll do it for you. Now, it's not 100% free because they do charge you. They take about 25% of whatever savings they get for you using this app, but it's still worth it because if something drops by, you know, $40 or $50 and they take, you know, 25% of that and you still get a, you know, $30 something, you know, cash back, that's a good deal. So it's a way you can shop with confidence and know you get the best price.
My goodness, this is a plethora of information. Thank you so much. The Money Coach, you always give us what we need. Definitely want to have you come back in 2019 to tell us about what's going on.
That new credit score.
Yeah, that new credit score. Okay, so if you want more money-saving tips, please go to her website, askthemoneycoach.com.